Howdy, this is Juana Stepper from Fiasco Sports, reporting on behalf of the SA Footballer magazine. Right now we're doing our Division 1 weekly roundup, and we're joined today by head coach of Adelaide University, John Paynter. Thanks for coming in, mate.
Cheers, Juan.
No worries. All right, to get things started, we're going to go take a look at last weekend's Round 3 results. First up, undefeated Tea Tree Gully got up over Ross Trevor by 27 points. Goodwood Saints were also in the winners column, beating Port District by 18 points. Meanwhile, Paynham delivered, defeating Sacred Heart Old Scholars by 35 points. Ladder leaders Henley continued their streak, beating Salisbury North by 25 points. And in good news for your boys, you got your first win of the season with Adelaide University defeating Portland by 62 points. Obviously a good result for you guys. How did the game go?
Yeah, well, it was tight early, and having the first win of the year was good, even though it was early in the year. No, terrific result.
So who was best on? Who were those really key performers for you?
I think we had two outstanding players. Brad Watson, who trains with the Crows, and Brad Davis, who didn't play for us last year, but instead played cricket in England. Two of those boys did very, very well.
Yeah, he's a multi-talented sort of guy then.
He certainly is. He captains, you know, Sturt District Cricket Club while he plays district cricket here, so he's very good.
Very good. What about the other games in the round? Did any of the results that we sort of went through shock you, or was it sort of the norm?
It wasn't a shock. Reportedly, Tea Tree Gully are as strong as, you know, Goodwood Saints were last year. And the other result from last week is interesting. I found that we couldn't get over Sacred Heart, but Paynham accounted for Sacred Heart quite comfortably.
We'll now move on to the upcoming games, and we'll go out John's tip for next week. All right then, John, who wins between Goodwood Saints and Ross Trevor?
Last year's grand finalist, I've seen Ross Trevor. They're still travelling pretty well, but just Goodwood just find a way to win.
Yep.
Probably by a small margin, less than two goals, 11 points.
Okay. What about when Paynham meet Portland?
Paynham will comfortably beat Portland. Unfortunately, Portland might have a longish year ahead of them.
How many points do you think?
Henley beat them by 65, we beat them by 10 goals. I think they'll probably surpass that margin, depending on weather, you know, around the 10-goal mark.
And your tip for Tea Tree Gully versus Sacred Heart?
Tea Tree Gully, too strong. Sacred Heart are impressive, but Tea Tree Gully have obviously got the goods this year.
Who's going to get it between Salisbury North when they play Port District?
That's the one that will shape the middle of the ladder. Premiership points. Not seeing either of them, I think that still that the individual talent of Port Districts might get them over the line by a very small margin, maybe 18 points.
Then obviously we have your game, and you have a tough one meeting, you know, ladder leaders Henley. What's the tip?
Well, we've been within 2 and 3 goals in the last couple of years without ever threatening. We've got a reasonable side in next week. We're hopeful of just being a home match. We just think we can just get over the line, but against a team that plays good footy. Yeah. So we're hoping for 1 or 2 goal victory. We'll take anything.
Yeah, no worries. What's the key to winning? You know, it's a very tough game. You've said it yourself, going to be a close one. What do you have to get on top in?
We just have to take our chance when they arise. We know that we're not going to have it all our own way. So when the opportunities arise, we just need to kick the goal and hit them on the scoreboard.
Just to finish, it's still early in the season. You guys are doing all right. You're still amongst it, around 6th on the ladder. What's your goal for the team this season?
Isn't that funny? You know, like last week, we look at the Premiership ladder, 2 rounds, we're undefeated. We're only two teams without a win. All of a sudden, we have a win and we're, you know, in the top six. So it's too early in the season. So the pessimists will say, gee, we're trying to avoid relegation. The pessimists are saying we're still trying to find finals. So still too early in the season.
Okay, no worries. Well, there you have it. That's this week's Division 1 Weekly Roundup, with a special thanks to John Paynter of the Adelaide University.